we are going to demonstrate the brachial plexus. As you all know, brachial plexus is a nerve plexus that supplies the upper limb muscles. So brachial plexus is formed by the anterior primary branches of C5, C6, C7, C8 and T1. So the C5, C6, C7, C8 and T1, the five spinal cord segments, anterior primary rami, will fuse, then divide, fuse and divide and produce multiple branches which contain nerve fibers of more than one segment to supply the appropriate muscles in the upper limb. So the root and the trunk stage will be present in the posterior triangle in the neck of the individual. The divisions will be formed beneath the clavicle. The divisions will then divide to form cords which will be present in the axilla. First, let us see the formation of brachial plexus. It is formed by the anterior primary rami of C5, C6, C7, C8 and T1. The C5, C6 anterior primary rami will fuse to form the upper trunk of brachial plexus. The C7 anterior primary rami will continue as middle trunk of brachial plexus. The C8 anterior primary rami and T1 anterior primary rami will fuse to form the lower trunk of brachial plexus. So C5, C6 upper trunk, C7 middle trunk, C8 and T1 lower trunk. These roots and the trunks are present in the posterior triangle of the neck between two muscles called scalenus anterior anteriorly and scalenus medius posteriorly. Then each of these trunks will divide into anterior division and posterior division. This is anterior division of upper trunk and posterior division of upper trunk. This is anterior division of middle trunk. This is posterior division of middle trunk. This is anterior division of lower trunk. This is posterior division of lower trunk. So anterior division of upper trunk, anterior division of middle trunk, anterior division of lower trunk, posterior division of the upper trunk, posterior division of middle trunk and posterior division of lower trunk. So this trunk and the root stages are present in the posterior triangle of the neck. The division stages are present beneath the clavicle, where they cross beneath the clavicle to reach the axilla. So this is a cervicoaxillary canal which they have taught you in the class of axilla, through which the divisions will pass and then they will then fuse to form various cords of brachial plexus. The cords are formed how I will demonstrate. They will be seen in the axilla. First, let us see the cords. The anterior division of upper trunk and the anterior division of middle trunk will form the lateral cord of brachial plexus. The anterior division of the lower trunk will continue as medial cord of brachial plexus. The posterior divisions of upper trunk, middle trunk and lower trunk will together form the posterior cord of brachial plexus. So totally there are three cords. Anterior division of upper trunk and middle trunk form the lateral cord. Anterior division of lower trunk continue as medial cord. The posterior divisions of upper, middle and lower trunk forms the posterior cord. These cords will be seen in the axilla. How they are related to the axillary artery, we will see in the next cadaver. See about the branches of brachial plexus. First, let us see the branches from the root. The C5 will give a communicating twig to form the phrenic nerve. This is a nerve which supplies the diaphragm, formed by C3, C4 and C5. You can see the C5 giving a twig to it. So this nerve will run on the surface of scalenus anterior muscle and enter into the thorax. Then from all the roots, small muscular branches will be given to the muscles in this neck region. From C5, another branch is given, called as dorsal scapular nerve, which will go to the posterior side to supply the muscles in the back. Then C5, C6 and C7 roots will give a branch which will supply the serratus anterior muscle. So this is the long thoracic nerve which supplies the serratus anterior, formed by C5, C6 and C7 roots. These three roots will join together to form the long thoracic nerve, which will pass posterior to the brachial plexus throughout its course and reaches the lateral side of the chest wall, where it is plastered to the serratus anterior muscle arising from the outer surface of the ribs. So this is the long thoracic nerve with its roots given by C5, C6 and C7. C5, C6 and C7. This is C5 root. This is C6. This is C7. C5 will supply the first two digitations. C6 will supply the next two digitations. C7 will supply the lateral last four digitations. So let us see the branches from the root once again. C5 root will give a communication to the phrenic nerve, forming root value with C3, C4, C5. Then C5 also gives a dorsal scapular nerve, which supplies the muscles in the back, rhomboids major, rhomboids minor and levator scapulae. Then C5, C6, C7 roots will give long thoracic nerve of bell, which supplies the serratus anterior muscle. Now to the branches of the divisions. So this is the upper trunk formed by C5, C6 root. This is anterior division of upper trunk. This is the posterior division of upper trunk. So from this junction, a branch is given. A small cut twig you can see here. This is nerve to subclavius with root value of C5 and C6. There is another nerve here arising from this junction called a suprascapular nerve. This also has got root value C5 and C6. Then the rest of the anterior division will join with the anterior division of middle trunk to form the lateral cord. The posterior division will join with the rest of the posterior cords to form the rest of the posterior divisions to form the posterior cord. So this junction where five nerves meet, C5, C6, anterior division, posterior division, nerve to subclavius and suprascapular nerve. So C5, C6 upper trunk, anterior division, posterior division, nerve to subclavius and suprascapular nerve. This point is the Erb's point. Root value is C5 and C6.